Hey everyone, welcome back to Measure and Mix. Thanks for stopping by today. If you're new here and like DIYs, make sure to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on anything new. Today I'm participating in the Look for Less challenge for the month of April. I have participated in this challenge in the past. It's so much fun to do. It's where you take a piece of high-end home decor and you recreate it for less. This challenge is hosted by Yami from the Latina Next Door, and she hosts this every month with a different co-host. This month, her co-host is Lindsay from Domer Home. I love watching these two ladies' channels. They are so creative and so talented. If you don't know who they are already, you should. I will leave their links down below in my description box so you can check them out. And there will be a playlist created for this challenge, so you can click on that to check out everyone else's Look for Less, and that will be located in the description box as well. For my Look for Less, I have always wanted a planter urn for outside on my patio. So I was looking around and I found this one on Grandin Road, but unfortunately it is well out of my budget. It's over $140 and I just can't swing that. So I am going to try to recreate it with some Dollar Tree items for under $10. So let's get started.
All right, so I'm going to start out with one of these square containers and then a 3-pack of these small containers. I'm just going to use one of them, and a medium-sized planter and then a larger planter from Dollar Tree. I'm going to put the square planter on the bottom upside down and then take the tiniest planter and place that upside down on top of the square planter, and then use some construction adhesive to glue those two pieces together. I already had the construction adhesive from a different project already on hand, so that did not cost me anything, so that was great. And I just put some around the edges and then I wiped the excess off with a wet paper towel. Next, I placed the medium-sized planter on top of the smaller planter, and I just again used some construction adhesive to glue them together. Next, I had a bag of some rocks from Dollar Tree, so I went ahead and added that to the bottom of this pot just to weight it down a little bit. Lastly, I went ahead and placed some more construction adhesive around the inner rim of the medium-sized container, and then I placed the large green container inside that medium container and glued those together. Next, to give the planter a more cohesive look, I used some glossy black spray paint. It only cost a dollar, and I just gave the whole thing 2 or 3 coats of spray paint. I made sure I got the inside inner rim as well in case you could see it when you planted the plants. And then when I was done and it was all dry, I came back with some shellac in clear coat that I had out in my garage already, and I just went over that so that way hopefully the paint won't chip in the weather. After the paint was all dry, the urn was complete, so I went ahead and decided to add some dirt and some ivy and flowers to it to kind of try to make it look like the picture a little bit more. Of course, mine's not as full as theirs. Hopefully, it will grow and be really full. And then I decided to take one of these Dollar Tree hanging baskets and take the hanger off and just place it upside down inside the container to give it that height. And I think this turned out really good. It only cost me $4 or $5 to make, so definitely under $10. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to check out the other videos in the playlist. Thanks so much to Yami and Lindsay for hosting, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care. Bye-bye.